Okay, what are we doing here today, my Facebook and YouTube friends? Today, I'm using these hemp hearts, the Carre de Chanvre. Those are hulled hemp seed, and they're not cooked or anything like that. They're raw, as they were, except that the hulls are removed a bit. And we're going to turn those hemp hearts into this. Some nice, cool, clean hemp milk. It's very good. If it's filtered, it doesn't taste strange at all. Of course, it tastes, it has its own particular flavor as far as a milk substitute goes. But it's very good, fresh out of the fridge. It's nice and cold. But there are some steps before this, the hemp hearts become the milk. So, all right. Now here I have, one of these handheld style blenders with a good knife at the bottom, and that'll be for chopping up the hulled hemp seed into as finely as can be processed. And then as I go along, I'll add some water to it to so you have more milk from it, because it would be very thick. All right, so I'm going to add some hemp seed to this special container for using the handheld blender. Oh, and before I forget, I have a finishing vessel. Well, a vessel in which to let the hemp seed actually sediment to the bottom of the container, and once it's sedimented at the bottom of the container, then I'll be able to just pour off the best of it. And if I really need to, I have an extra filtration device, which is it's not purposely designed for making hemp milk. But the screen in it is a very fine filter, and it seems to make milk that looks like this, and it tastes very clear as well. All right. All right, I'm back to add the hemp seed to the container for blending. Finer processing. Yeah, I'm gonna add a cup. It's probably a lot, but okay, one cup of hemp seed. And I'm not going to add too much water. See, I want that to be very thick, so that it'll help the material to, be a finer. I apologize for the noise. It makes it for a bit of an obnoxious video, but at least it gives the an idea of how long. because I really want the hemp seed to be processed as finely as possible. Get the to make it milk. Now I'm going to add the ground up hemp seed and water to this jug. And I'm going to rinse that out. Add a bit more water. All right. And now I'm going to let that sediment in the fridge, and I will be back to decant it and filter it later. All right, as you can see, I make the hemp milk a little bit thick, maybe thicker than it should be, but I can thin it out or leave it as thick as I like. I like the fact that I can actually choose the texture by doing it this way, just adding water till it's right. In this case, what I'm going to be doing is a test. The most interesting test that I could come up with, there were many scientific, complex scientific methods that were available that I could have used to analyze the milk, and but I like the just making observations using my own senses. Like, to me, that's a very good milk. It's very thick as well. It's not something that's thin. I could make it thinner, but the ultimate test that I could come up with was to answer this very deep scientific question that people are probably wondering about concerning hemp milk is, can I make strawberry quick with hemp milk? So here it is, the strawberry quick syrup. In it goes. Alright. Now this gets very scientific here. This is where I add the scientific instrument, the spoon. And we're going to stir. We're going to watch all the flavors in that syrup. They seem to be quite soluble in the hemp milk. So I'm gonna give that a taste. But remember, this is extreme science. Wow. Hemp milk makes strawberry quick that tastes as good or better than milk from a dairy cow. Yeah, I mean, to me, it's at least as good. I really enjoy this. It's actually dangerous. It's kind of addictive. All right, guys. I just noticed after making that glass of strawberry quick from hemp milk There is a sediment at the bottom of the container there. And that sediment is like a paste. A very thick paste. Yeah. So that's another substance that we can gather from the making of hemp milk as well. And also it tells me that I could probably make a whole lot more milk from the hemp seed that I grind up. But yeah, I've really enjoyed anyways the milk that I've had so far. I know I've made it thicker than it should probably be, so I don't know. I think an $8 a pound, a person can reasonably make quite a bit more hemp milk than they can for, say, compared to the same amount of dairy milk for $8. So you have quite a bit more hemp milk for the same, you know, dollar value. Yeah. So far it has many uses. You know, for anybody's budget, it's a great life hack to have, to be able to make, you know, take hemp seed and make as much milk as you need in the form that you need it, the consistency or the texture that you would like it to have as well. Yeah, and that, the hemp, the strawberry quick made with the hemp milk, that tasted exactly like strawberry ice cream that's melted. It was very, very good. Kind of an interesting treat. Okay. Yeah, and it's a real wonder. It's a wonder to think all the, all the lactose intolerant people in the world who never had a glass of strawberry quick. And, you know, and the way that this tastes with the hemp milk, well, they can, you know, they can experience the strawberry flavored quick, which is probably better than the strawberry quick from the dairy cow. Yeah, all the people that can now have a glass of strawberry quick and know what those flavors taste like, what that experience is. Yeah, it's not something that I drink every day, but it's, you know, it was something of a flavor that had marked me in my life, you know, to think back in my past and to see what flavors do I remember that stand out. You know, was it the in Asian cooking, what do I remember? The ginger. Or the Mexican food was the ground Mexican chili. And I think of, you know, North American life in the 80s and 90s, and I think, you know, strawberry quick was definitely sort of a symbol of that era and the way things were done, that things were in syrups and concentrates. And of course these companies have since gone back and had to, you know, they changed their concentrates so that they can be healthier and they can meet health standards and guidelines. And a lot of these products are probably healthier than they were. Even the ketchup, you think Heinz ketchup used to come out of one size of a hole in a bottle, and today it comes out of a much smaller hole with a lot less coaxing. So that tells us that, you know, the texture is different, the recipe is different, something is different with the ketchup, so that it could go through, you know, the small hole in the squeeze bottle form of ketchup, which exists nowadays. Okay, well, I've gone completely off course here. All right, I'm still waiting for the the hemp milk to sediment a little bit longer before decanting it. I'll be back with that. Okay, so this is the result of the hemp milk processing after the sedimentation at the bottom of the vessel. The solution above the sediment at the bottom, this I can now decant off and set that aside. And I have a filter here, which is fine enough and suitable for this purpose. It's not made for that. It's actually for making a coffee without a filter. As much as possible, I try to do things without using a filter. But, you know, I'm doing this quickly. So, because I could just let the, you know, let this loose solution sediment naturally, which I have for the most part. I'm just practicing making a very nice milk with all the texture of milk. On the other hand, I'm fairly certain that I could make more. I could use more water. This is awesome. To me, this is like the cow that never is empty. This makes a lot of milk. Alright, there we go. Now that it's filtered, I am going to set it aside in another vessel. I know it looks crazy, but it's because it's the filtering vessel. I need it back, if possible. Alright, now I can continue the decanting and filtering. The filter is handy at the end here, or if I want to get the very last of the liquid. I don't know if you guys can see in there. Alright, I'm going to be careful not to have any sediment fall in the... the sediment will have I'll find a purpose for that as well. At the same time, I'm fairly certain that if I add water, I can extract more milk from this as well. So I'm gonna try that actually right now. Oh, cold water. I'm gonna try and just use enough water to fill this vessel here. I'm gonna set it back to sediment a while. This can sediment. This is nice and clean. It's a very nice texture as it stands. I'm gonna try it just to see the thickness of it actually. You kind of have to taste it to have a sense of how thick the milk is. Wow, that's really nice. I like this. This is very, very good. Like I said, it's the cow that's never empty. And, you know, it's... no animals were hurt in the process, if that's important to you. Wow, that is so good. Alright, like I said, I'm going to let this sediment, and I'll have a bit more milk from that as well. This is awesome milk. And I think for, like I said, $8 a pound of dehulled hemp seed, the milk that's there, I could stretch it out quite a bit. I mean, if we, I were to make it a texture similar to store-bought milk, I could, you know, I could water that down quite a bit. But I like how it tastes now, and it's still, you know, there's no grit to it or anything like that. It's very fine. Yeah, it's a very nice liquid. And now what is left is to, you know, try it in different recipes. Where does it work as a substitute for milk? Probably in many cases. All cases? I don't know. So. Yeah. So, and like I said, it's the, you know, we could, you could have milk for the entire world on hemp seed. And I think it's probably a cheaper and a healthier milk. And even if it were the same price, I think it's probably healthier. They provide a lot of omega-3s, these hemp seed. So when you look at the nutritional information on the side of the packaging, they tell you exactly how many grams of omega-3s and omega-6s, those molecules, it turns out. Especially, well, I know for the omega-3s and possibly the omega-6s as well, some studies that were done and the results were published, filed at the National Library of Medicine in the United States, and they stated that they had observed that omega-3s via the human biochemical pathways were able to turn into cannabinoids. And some of the other studies that were published that I looked at stated that these cannabinoids, no matter their source, you know, whether it be from the plant or from the human biochemistry, all cannabinoids, that they were shown to cause apoptosis of cancerous cells, meaning it they cause cell death, kills cancer, in layman's terms, if you will. So, yeah, the stuff, you know. Apparently the omega-3s turn into some cancer-fighting molecules. So they're... even though that, you know, this stuff isn't psychoactive or it's not going to get you high, it still does have a very important potential effect in the treatment of cancer. Alright, now on to finishing the decantation of the, or the decanting of the now sedimented solution. I'm gonna pour that through the filter. Okay, so that has most of it. What's left is really the sediment here. So I'm going to make room in the glass pitcher, and I'll be right back. so there's more than a half liter of hemp milk here. And that's that. One full pitcher. Alright, so I'm back to, here's the hemp milk. I have quite a bit of it there, prepared. And I have four glasses here. And the four glasses are for four different taste tests. First of all, I'm going to taste some hemp milk as it is, and I'm going to make another glass of hemp milk, but I'm going to add approximately 50% more water, which is okay, and all right, another glass. These two are separate. All right. So now I'm going to taste just the hemp milk by itself. Cheers. Very good. I would expect, you know, more of a nutty flavor or something like along those lines, but no, it's not an unpleasant flavor. Okay, so this was the hemp milk without the extra, yeah, this was just the pure hemp milk. This is the hemp milk with 50% more water added. I'm going to see what that tastes like, what the texture is. It looks right, so. Oh, it's still very good. This could easily, quite easily be served as an excellent milk still, with 50% more water added. You can maybe even, you know, make two jugs like this. Very good, very good. And now I'm going to try something. I'm going to make hemp milk, and I'm going to add some coconut milk to the hemp milk for tasting. See how that tastes. I'm going to do the same with the other one. I think I'm gonna add a bit more hemp milk, so. Oops, spilled the milk. But that's okay, because this cow's never empty. Awesome, awesome. So now, I'm gonna stir the both glasses that contain half hemp milk. Oh, no. Say two-thirds hemp milk and one-third of coconut milk. It's probably a lot. Okay, so I'm back with the, this is the hemp and coconut milk. This could pass for a glass of milk. It doesn't need that much coconut though. But yeah, the both of them together are very, they're excellent. Let's see. Yeah, hemp milk alone. The hemp milk alone is very good. With the coconut milk, it's slightly sweeter, but it has a, you know, it reminds me more of milk, you know, dairy from a cow. A little bit more. All right, and for the last one, the last glass containing the 2/3 hemp milk and 1/3 coconut milk, I'm going to make a strawberry quick using the hemp milk and coconut milk. So here goes. All right. So, I'll have had the experience of, you know, the different forms of this milk that I can make. I like the coconut a lot just because it's very healthy as well. It's part of the there are oils in the coconut, or there's a substance which is useful in the brain, if I remember well, they're called ketones. And there are other they have they support a part of the brain's biochemistry there, to put it the best way. So, yeah, the omega-3s along with the ketones that are found in the coconut milk. And, yeah, I've committed, you know, hemp milk sacrilege by putting this, you know, some fake artificial flavor syrup in the milk. I know, I understand it's sacrilege, but it's just to, you know, to see the different forms that, you know, of milk that I can produce here. For years I had to stop consuming milk until I started to eat cannabinoids. And then I could consume dairy products again. A little more. But yeah, this hemp milk allows me to consume, you know, products that require the milk or the milk texture, and I can have them without having the digestive issues that really they cost me a lot of energy. Had I known when I was young, when I was in school, I used to eat a, you know, a bowl of cereal like your average North American child before going to school. And but it took me years to realize, and it's only looking back that I noticed that I was digesting that milk until noon. So I was very, very tired till it had finally, you know, made its way through my system. And then I would be more alert in the afternoons. So Yeah. Okay, so one more time. This was the hemp milk with 50% more water. You know, the texture is still fairly thick, and I would, you know, this would be an acceptable milk to my by my taste. This is the texture of the milk that has, you know, maybe we can compare them. Okay, 50% more water, and you know, that's without dilution, or before dilution. Yeah. This has 50% more water. This is as it came from the pitcher there. Yeah. And of course, this is you know, kind of a novelty milk with a lot of coconut milk in it, but it's very good, and I wouldn't have to use so much coconut milk. I think it would be just fine. And here's the texture of the strawberry hemp milk.